Hi all, welcome to the add-on course Professional Ethics conducted by Department of Computer Science and Applications, Safi Institute of Advanced Study, Warrior. Let me introduce myself. I am Mohammed Hanish KP, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Applications, CS. Today we are going to discuss some topics. They are morals. The topics are morals, values, ethics, integrity, work ethic, service learning, civic virtue, respect for others, and honesty. Now we deal with these three things: values, morals, and ethics. Let's start with values. These are the foundation of a person's ability to judge between right and wrong. So these are fundamental beliefs that guide or motivate attitudes or actions, help us to determine what is important to us. Values describes the personal qualities we choose to embody to guide our actions, the sort of person we want to be, the manner in which we treat ourselves and others, and our interaction with the world around us. So they have intrinsic worth but are not universally accepted. This system allows each individual to determine what should and what shouldn't be. Now moving to next topic, we have morals. Morals are what you believe to be right and wrong. People can have different morals. You might say, I like his morals, or I wonder about his morals. Your morals are your ideas about right and wrong, especially how you should act and treat other people. Most people would agree that thieves, murderers, and other criminals are lacking morals. A lot of people would say politicians could use some morals as well. Every person has a slightly different set of morals, and different cultures have their own morals as well. You probably get your morals from a combination of your parents, your teachers, your culture, and your religion. So, morals are specific and context-driven rules that govern a person's behavior, because this system of belief is individually tailored to a person's life experience. It's subject to opinion. Moving to our next topic, we have ethics. It is a system of moral principles. They affect how people make decisions and lead their lives. Ethics is concerned with what is good for individuals and society, and is also described as moral philosophy. The term ethics is derived from the Greek word ethos, which can mean custom, habit, character, or disposition. So ethics enact the system we have developed in our moral code. As such, someone will behave ethically or unethically. In morals, first principle rarely changes, and ethics, we have external rules may vary between environments. Now, our next topic, integrity. It deals with the exhibiting fairness and honesty in all professional and personal relations. It is considered as a personal choice which is uncompromising under any kind of circumstances. So integrity is the elementary value for any profession, and it is important for all those who exhibit strong moral and ethical principles. Now moving to our next topic, work ethic. It is a belief that hard work and diligence have a moral benefit and an inherent ability, virtue, or value to strengthen character and individual abilities. So it is a set of values concerned on importance of work and manifested by determination or desire to work hard. Now, moving in this work ethic, we have the following parameters to consider: honesty, dependability, responsibility, dedication, team leader, goal oriented, professionalism, punctuality, and reliability. All these things. Now, moving to next topic, we have service learning. Service learning means it is an educational approach that combines learning objectives with a community service, or in order to provide a pragmatic progressive learning experience while meeting social needs. So we have several examples. So I tell you one example. Students in a biology class plant trees and grasses in wetland areas with a conservation group. Here we have learning objectives: knowledge of ecosystems, biodiversity, coastal erosion, plant life cycles, environmental degradation, etc. And coming to service objectives, we have mitigation of wetland loss, habitat preservation, stone protection, etc. So this is about service learning, and these are the parameters you have to consider in service learning: academic study, practical experience, and civic engagement. These things. Now, our next topic: civic virtue. It helps people understand their ties to the community and their responsibility within it in many ways. An educated citizen who possesses civic virtue is a public good. So civic virtue examines the definition of civic virtue as a morality or a standard of righteous behavior in citizens, righteous behavior in relationship to a citizen's involvement in society. So our last topic, honesty. We know that honesty is the best policy. That is, honesty implies being truthful. Honesty means to develop a practice to speaking truth throughout life. So a person who practices honesty in his life possesses strong moral character. This is about the topics. Thank you for listening to me.